You've done a great job securing your castle and the chickens. Now, your kingdom is expanding. Hi, my name's Kitty, and this season of the game, you have the chance to expand your network. In a larger network, there's more resources to gain, but more users to protect, just like in cybersecurity.
In cybersecurity, you can think about your larger network as the people and the machines that you connect with, and the people and machines that they connect with, all radiating outwards in a large web. One of the benefits of being part of a larger network is that sense of community and connectedness you get from being part of something with other people, and the fact that they can help you when you really need it. One of the risks of being part of a larger network is that sometimes there are people in your larger network who are not there because you chose them to be there, and sometimes those people might not be so nice.
Not only are we all connected as part of the larger network, we form the different parts that make up our supply chain.
A supply chain is an entire system of producing or delivering a product or service.
This is true of not just software, but everything in your life, including your food, your clothing, your cars, everything. Supply chains are all around us.
So the best way to think about the supply chain is a pen. The pen has plastic, it has ink on the inside, and it has a metal tip on the top. All of these things have to come together to create the pen. The pen needs to get sent to me by a vehicle or via a truck before it gets into my hand. These coming together creates this end product of the pen. A supply chain is how all those things come together to create an effect.
On the one hand, being part of the supply chain means you don't have to do all the work. On the other, it means you have to trust everybody in that supply chain. Trying to keep this balanced can be hard. Luckily, we have lots of different types of intelligence to help.
Intelligence in cybersecurity is the information that we use to inform our decision-making processes.
You can think about intelligence as gathering information about what the other side is doing and what they could be capable of doing.
Human intelligence is what we receive by interacting with people. I guess it's probably the oldest form of intelligence.
In my job, I get a lot of cybersecurity intel from the people I work with. When we're talking together, even when we're gossiping, it helps to find out what they're dealing with so that I know what I can plan for.
Signals intelligence is what we get from machines and devices, and humans typically use that to gain additional context.
One of the best ways to discover if our protections are working is by thinking like a threat.
Penetration testing in cybersecurity is the process of checking that something is secure by pretending to be a bad person. By playing out a bad person, we can give defenders an opportunity to understand how well secured their system is, where they're doing things right, where they can improve, and how they can respond to a problem playing out.
Penetration testing is extremely important in cybersecurity because if you can find out the weak spots in your systems before the attackers do, then you actually have a chance to fix it before you get attacked.
You need to secure your supply chain, gather intelligence, and test your defenses to protect your larger network. Let's get to it.